because if you take a look at Kamala Harris, who is starting to do a few little interviews here and there, she popped up on a podcast called Call Her Daddy. It's one of the most popular podcasts in the world, apparently. I can't say that I'm a listener. You're probably not either. But, yes, it is one of the most popular podcasts in the world, worth millions of dollars. The woman who hosts it recently signed a deal for upwards of $60 million US, I think it is, to host this thing. So it is big deal stuff. But she was asked the big question on Call Her Daddy: why is it that you don't do a lot of sit-down interviews, you know, traditional format where you're there with a hard-hitting journalist who's going to ask you the questions that you need to give a real response to? Why are you not doing that, and why are you talking to me instead? And, well, Kamala Harris said nothing, really.
I'm curious, like, you don't do too many long-form interviews. What made you want to do Call Her Daddy today?
Well, I think you and your listeners have really got this thing right, which is one of the best ways to communicate with people is to be real, you know, and to talk about the things that people really care about. I mean, what I love about what you do is that your voice and your show is really about your listeners.
What? The show is about the listeners. Yeah, isn't every show? I mean, this show's about the viewers. When you go and do a sit-down interview, you know, at Fox News or CNN or where, it's about the viewers. What does she think the media is? Oh, it's real. It's real. By which she means, I'm coming here because I know that you're not going to ask me a hard question.
The other crazy thing she said there is she said, I love this podcast because the listeners are seen and heard. Well, actually, it's a podcast, so the listeners are not seen, and their listeners, they're not heard. But I'm just wondering what people would rather. Would you rather be seen and heard, or would you rather have the border crisis sorted and inflation come down? What's more important?
I mean, obviously, she does these because she knows it's going to be a free ride. You don't see her doing any one-on-ones, hard-hitting interviews, talking about policy on even the friendly networks. She's not popping up on CNN. She's not popping up on CSNBC. Even the people who are barracking for her, the networks that are giving the Democrats a tongue bath on the hour every single day in the lead-up to polling day, she's not going on there to do any hard-hitting questions because everybody knows at this point in time she's not up for it. So why on earth would you want that woman in the White House? Come on, America, restore our faith in you.